changed the face of music. Simple as that. That's what he did. He's changed the entire face of music.
I wanted to retrace my dad's footsteps, to let the world know the real Bob Moog.
As an instrument, it's one of the most important instruments, I think, in the history of music.
You're just one of the people that are lucky enough to find an instrument. That is revolutionary, that is pioneering, and it's that that changes everything.
You know, this is really cool. I really love these keyboards. It's a real instrument.
Bob's contribution to what everybody is doing today is huge.
I see we have part of your assortment of mini Moogs.
Well, I've got nine. This is amazing.
We kind of invented for television the whoosh and the suck.
Robert said himself, I'm no businessman, and he wasn't.
There's a corporate structure, and it's out there, it's got to make money, it's got to feed the beast.
He was not interested in mass production. The staff was, because we wanted to continue the company.
He was running into a close to bankruptcy problems.
I think your dad's fame in some ways got in the way.
What's your earliest memory of Dad?
The first thing that pops on mind is he was gone a lot.
Living with Robert was lonelier than if you lived by yourself.
Did he talk to you about going through the divorce with my mom?
There's not a lot I want to say about this.
I leaned down and I kissed him on the cheek and I told him I loved him. That's the last time I saw him.
I don't think he's left me, really. I get teary when I talk about him.
Even in death, he is still the godfather of it all.